Good evening, everyone. I'm Carrie Lazarus.
And I'm James Gaddis, in for Ron, who is home tonight recovering after prostate cancer surgery. He had the procedure a week ago today, and he is doing well.
Yes, we're very happy to report that, and also happy to report that Rod's doctor and other specialists from Crouse Hospital are with us in the newsroom tonight to raise awareness about prostate cancer and answer your questions. You can call them at 446-9999. Now, Rod's two older brothers had prostate cancer. They are survivors, but Rod has been very vigilant for that reason about getting checked. You are a very private person. What made you decide to share this with Central New York?
Well, I think it's important that every man know that sooner or later they could develop prostate cancer, and the time to safeguard your health is now. Get the PSA exam and also the digital exam.
In the newsroom now, along with the other specialists from Crouse Hospital, is Rod's doctor, Dr. Harvey Sauer, urologist from Crouse. Dr. Sauer, welcome and thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
We understand that Rod gave you permission to talk about how he's doing, so tell us. He sounds good on the phone, but how is he doing?
Well, I'm happy to report that he's doing very well. The surgery was exactly a week ago today. He's home and recovering nicely.
And what about returning to work? He's hoping to be back before the end of the month.
Well, if things go as they have been, I see no reason why he couldn't.
All right. Well, let's talk a little bit about who's at risk, because Rod clearly had a strong family history. Not only did his two older brothers have prostate cancer, but he had an uncle. I want to show a graphic to our viewers of the risk factors for prostate cancer. Can we take a look at that and talk about who is at risk? First of all, we have people, men over the age of 65. This is something that happens as men get older, right?
No question. It's probably the biggest risk factor. As men get older, their chances of developing prostate cancer increase significantly.
All right. And then a family history, of course. Being black, black men have a much higher risk than whites, don't they?
Yes. African American men not only have a higher risk of prostate cancer, but they have a higher risk of more serious or high-grade prostate cancer, so they need to be screened even earlier.
And what about obesity? Why does that play a role in putting men at risk?
Well, it's not known exactly why obese men are at higher risk from prostate cancer. It probably has to do with hormone changes that obese men go through.
Mm-hmm. Now, one in five men will develop prostate cancer, but the number of men who die from prostate cancer is much lower than that. This is a slow-growing cancer most often, isn't it?
Most often it is. Not always, and men should be aware of that. And we'll be talking about screening later, apparently, in the program. But it is true that most men who develop prostate cancer do not actually die of it.
It's good news. All right, Dr. Harvey Sauer, thank you so much for being with us. I know we have men who want to call you and ask some questions. And again, the number is 446-9999. Coming up a little bit later, we'll be talking about PSA testing and the physical exam and some of the things that men might be able to do to prevent prostate cancer. And we'll also be talking about the robotic surgery that Rod had. So stay with us for more coverage. Jane? Jim Boeheim, Joe Torre, Rudy Giuliani, Don Imus, Arnold Palmer, some of the very famous faces who have been diagnosed with prostate cancer in recent years. And joining that list now is News Channel 9's Rod Wood, who was diagnosed a few weeks ago and is home now recovering from surgery for prostate cancer. Now, Rod has been very vigilant about getting screened because both of his brothers and an uncle had prostate cancer. His most recent PSA blood test raised a red flag.
My PSA level had been about 4.0, but in my most recent checkup, the PSA level jumped from 4.0 to 5.4. My doctor said his alarm system went off, and he recommended me to a urologist to find out what's going on.
What was going on was that Rod did, in fact, have prostate cancer. That simple blood test, the PSA test, is what alerted doctors to the possibility. And joining us now from Crouse Hospital is Dr. Richard Kronhaus. Dr. Kronhaus, obviously the PSA was a red flag for Rod. There's been some controversy about whether all men should get it starting at age 40 or 50. In your mind, it's an important part of prostate cancer screening, right?
Absolutely. It's
not a perfect test, but it's at least as good as a mammogram in terms of its screening potential.
Now, it assigns a number. What does the number mean? Rod said his went from a 4 to over a 5. What do the numbers mean?
Well, the numbers are a measurement of the amount of the enzyme, but the number itself isn't as important, although there are thresholds, there are normal ranges. But of recent, our national organization has determined that the number's not as important as the relative change from one exam to the next.
So if you go from one number, you know, after several months or years, and all of a sudden it changes, that might be the red flag.
That's right. Okay. We would like to see it not go more than 0.75 in 1 year.
Okay. Now, we're going to look at a graphic now which shows when men should be screened. If you're at the age of 50, the general recommendation is this is when you should start with an annual physical exam and a PSA blood test. You're in agreement with that?
More or less. Our national organization actually has last year suggested that men start at age 40. There's a little bit of controversy when you should start and who you should start with.
Okay, well, the graphic again, let's go back to that for a moment, because between 40 and 45 is when high-risk men, like, you know, somebody with a family history, maybe African-American men, maybe men who are obese, What would be your recommendation at high risk? Should you start even earlier than 40?
I think men at high risk should start at 40.
Okay.
And those would be people that have a strong family history, two members of the same family, African Americans.
Right. But even if you don't have a family history, that's any man over the age of 65 is at risk for prostate cancer, because that's the number one risk factor is age, right?
Age is, in fact, the number one after gender.
Yeah. Do men get it at 50?
Yes, although it's not as common. The reason for screening earlier is that men that get it at 50 are more likely to die from it because they have a longer period to be exposed to the ill effects of the disease.
All right, so start the screening maybe at 40, but certainly at 50. Dr. Richard Kronhaus, thank you so much. We'll let you get back to the phones. The phones are busy, so if you do have a question for the doctors, be patient. The number is 446-9999. And coming up in the Family Health Cast, we'll talk about the robotic surgery that Rod had. It is the Da Vinci, and we'll talk with one of the leading national experts on this type of prostate surgery a little bit later in the HealthCast. Jane? Well, as we continue our health alert on prostate cancer, Rod Wood is used to reporting the news. He is now the subject of a news story as he's been diagnosed with prostate cancer and is now at home recovering from surgery. Rod had the latest in technology in prostate surgery. A surgeon at Crouse Hospital used the Da Vinci robot to remove the prostate. Joining us now is the chief of urology at Crouse Hospital, Dr. David Albala. And Dr. Albala, why is the Da Vinci such a good option for men who choose to have surgery?
Well, I think robotic surgery offers three major advantages. One, the blood loss is much less than what we saw with open surgery. Two, the visualization is much better. You can see the blood vessels. And three, the recovery time is very quick. Typically, these patients are in the hospital a day or two and then go home. The catheter stays in place. And that's a significant improvement from a 2 to 3 day hospitalization versus, and also a catheter being in place for 2 weeks or so.
Rod was home within 48 hours, and that was something that it was very important to him. I want to show our viewers a graphic of the different treatment options, because every man who's diagnosed with prostate cancer has a decision to make. Surgery is one of the options. Chemotherapy is another. Hormone therapy with radiation, Rudy Giuliani chose that, and that got a lot of press. Also cryotherapy, where they freeze the prostate. The one that's intriguing is the watchful waiting. Some men do nothing but just keep an eye on it with the doctor, right?
Well, we know a couple things about the natural history of prostate cancer. It's a very slow-growing tumor. And men that are diagnosed at a younger age tend to have a much more aggressive form of cancer. We know that 197,000 men are diagnosed every year. About 25,000 men die of prostate cancer. So if I actually did an autopsy on men 70 and above, 70% of them would have prostate cancer.
Wow.
Now, what's interesting about that fact is that they don't all die of prostate cancer. They die of heart disease, lung disease. So active surveillance is very good.
All right, Dr. Albala, thank you very much. We have a lot more on the web about this, and we'll be talking more about the prevention of prostate cancer in a little bit. It's time now for a weather check.
Channel. For a complete list of what's available, just head to 9WSYR.com.
We are in the newsroom tonight with a health alert on prostate cancer. We've had a lot of response from those of you sending good wishes to Rod Wood, who is at home recovering from successful prostate cancer surgery. Rod has two brothers and an uncle who all had prostate cancer.
I said to the doctor, I said, how common is prostate cancer? He said, the truth be told, probably half the men walking down South Salina Street right now have prostate cancer and don't know it.
Really? Were you shocked to hear that?
I was shocked.
Well, that doctor is Rod's doctor, Harvey Sauer, who's a urologist from Crouse Hospital, who's joining us tonight along with his colleagues answering so many questions. Are you surprised at how many women have been calling Dr. Sauer about their husbands?
Not really. Historically, men are more concerned about their cars, and it seems like a lot of women are more concerned about prostate and prostate cancer.
Well, we appreciate your taking the time tonight. I want to talk a little bit about prevention, because there is some research that connects diet with the incidence of prostate cancer. I want to show viewers a graphic of things that they might want to avoid. Men might at an early age avoid things like animal fat, which comes from red meat, trans fats, avoiding a high calcium diet or preserved meats or salted foods. Would you advise patients to take this advice and avoid these types of foods as a way to prevent prostate cancer?
Well, there's not a lot of, a lot of real good data on dietary prevention of prostate cancer, but it does turn out that a so-called healthy heart diet is also a healthy prostate diet. So it's true that a low-fat, low-sodium, low-cholesterol diet seems to reduce the risk of prostate cancer to a certain extent. So the good news is that men will also be helping their heart when they're helping their prostate.
All right, well, Dr. Sauer, thank you again. And I do want to say that tomorrow evening at Crouse Hospital, there will be a prostate cancer informational seminar. It's at 6:30 at the Marley Education Center, and it is free. Parking is free as well. And before we wrap up our coverage on prostate cancer, we'd like to let Rod have the last word on this. And when this is all behind you, you're coming back to us, right?
I hope so, Carrie. I hope to be back here if I've got a crawl on my hands and knees.
He'll be fine. Thanks again, Rod, for sharing and for encouraging men to get screened. We appreciate that. We appreciate the doctors from Crouse Hospital. We have lots of information for you at 9WSYR.com.